It's been 5 weeks of protests, door knocking, and democracy in action. And this is the last big event, the government's campaign launch.
Welcome to the great state of Victoria for the 2019 coalition campaign launch. How good is Scott Morrison?
Well, you might be thinking, why is ScoMo launching this campaign just 6 days out from the election? Well, there's a reason for that. Between this launch and the election, ministers can't claim their usual taxpayer-funded travel allowance, so it's cheaper to have it later. Also, there are 5 planes on standby to fly the government and the opposition around the country. And it's legal for political parties to lie in their ads. These are just some of the things going on behind the scenes in election campaigns.
We see what the media decides to show us.
Jamila knows a lot about election campaigns. She was one of the minds behind the media strategy for the Rudd and Gillard governments.
You'll see Bill Shorten in Tasmania and you'll see Scott Morrison in New South Wales. It's probably because the parties have something called a tracking poll, which isn't the polling we see as the public, it's their own poll. And they drop it into marginal seats every single night. And they will actually use that to decide where they need to go.
I heard that there's a role called a flag fluffer. What is this?
I used to be a flag fluffer. During an election campaign, being in government is an advantage. So you want a lot of flags behind you to remind people that there are flag fluffers, yeah, to make sure the Union Jack looks, you know, quite right and make sure the stars are well aligned.
So politicians have a particular way of communicating and answering questions.
Fair go for Australia.
We can build our economy to secure your future.
A fair go for all Australians.
To secure your future.
How much training do they have?
There is quite a bit of training that goes into it. If you want the media to run the story, you give them fireworks and rainbows in the answers to their questions. If you don't want them to run the story, then you bore them shitless. Kevin, my old boss, quite good at that.
There's fucking language.
Don't let your reaction get caught on camera in a bad way. And always be looking for a hero moment. So you might have seen Scott Morrison, someone threw an egg at him, and he was most worried about an elderly lady near him. So he gets a moment to be the hero. You have to do those kind of human moments during a campaign, but it's very high risk because meeting with ordinary voters means ordinary voters can do crazy stuff like throw eggs at you, right?
I had people with me every day of the week, you know, protesters who are, you know, they're designed, it's part of the dirty tactics of politics to send people out to be confrontational, to film you, to get a gotcha moment out of it.
What kind of things would they say or do?
Well, just yelling, screaming, abusing. I mean, this is the really dark, bad parts of politics.
I wanted to hear about how the sausage is made from the horse's mouth. And by horse, I mean former youngest parliamentarian in Australian history, Wyatt Roy.
You had your first campaign when you were just 19 years old. Did you actually know what you were in for at that time? Did Tinder exist back then? Did you have it deleted?
Yeah, I mean, Tinder didn't exist, I don't think, at that point. But I definitely, like, the day I got pre-selected, I called up my mates and I said, please delete all the photos off Facebook, you know, get rid of everything from college.
What did they have to delete?
Just a few things, but I didn't remember to delete the pages that I liked on Facebook. So the day after I was pre-selected, the front page of the newspaper was, he's 19, he likes Victoria's Secret, KFC and State of Origin fights, and he wants to be a member of parliament. And I don't think it really hurt me with the voters, but...
Do you get a hard list of do's or don'ts?
What we get every morning is you get a list of these are the things you should say, these are the things you shouldn't say. There is a reason why the parties do that, because they want to stay on message. I very quickly started deleting those emails.
It's clear from Wyatt and Jamila's stories that all the handshaking, baby kissing, beer drinking, robotic slogans and hero moments are intentional. But do they work?
What I find really interesting about this election is how many people have already voted. So more than 1 million people will have voted before election day. And that's more than ever.
70% of Australians say they aren't really paying attention to this election, which begs the question, what are we doing wrong?
I think the great challenge for anybody in politics is to inspire the population. And I think the big thing that we've missed from politics in the last 10 years is conviction. You know, people want to see politicians who believe in something, will fight for it, and will change the country for the better, even if they don't agree with what that is.